ಸುರಜ ಜನರಂಜನ ಯಶೋದಾನಂದನ ವ್ರಜ ಜನರಂಜನ ಯಮುನತೀರ ವನಚಾರಿ ಯಶೋದಾನಂದನ ವ್ರಜ ಜನರಂಜನ ಯಶೋದಾನಂದನ ವ್ರಜ ಜನರಂಜನ ಯಮುನಾ ತೀರ ವನಚಾರಿ ಸಾದಿ ಭಕ್ತವೃಂದ
Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna,
जय ओम विष्णुपाद परमहंस प्रयुराजिकाचार्य अष्टोत्तर सत्य श्री श्री माधवय चरणारविंद भक्ति वेदांत स्वामी महाराज श्रील प्रभुपाद की जय। इस्कॉन फाउंडर आचार्य श्रील प्रभुपाद की जय। अनंत कोटि वैष्णव वृंद की जय। नामाचार्य श्रील हरिदास ठाकुर की जय। प्रेम से कहो श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर शिवासदि गौर भक्त वृंद की जय। श्री श्री राधा कृष्ण गोप गोपीनाथ श्याम कुंद राधा कुंद गिरी गौर धन की जय। श्री वृंदावन धाम की जय। श्री मायापुर धाम की जय। श्री नवदीप धाम की जय। श्री जगन्नाथपुरी धाम की जय। श्री गंगा माई श्री यमुना माई की जय। श्री भक्ति देवी श्री तुलसी देवी की जय। श्री हरि नाम संकीर्तन की जय। श्री बृहत प्रदंगा की जय। श्री श्रील प्रभुपाद ट्रांसेंडेंटल बुक डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन की जय। सामवेद भक्त वृंद की जय। जय निताय गौर प्रेमानंदे। ऑल ग्लोरीज टू द असेंबल्ड डिवोटीज। ऑल ग्लोरीज टू द असेंबल्ड डिवोटीज। All glories to the assembled devotees. All glories, all glories, all glories to the lotus feet of Sri Sri Guru and Sri Gauranga and Sri Srila Prabhupada. Hare Krishna. So I beg the mercy of all the Vaishnavas assembled here, feeling myself unqualified to speak. I beg for your mercy so that I can say something of value. Thank you very much. Thank you. So we are reading today from Srimad Bhagavatam, Canto 10, Chapter 82, Text 39. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय, ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय। श्री सुख उवाच, गोप्याश्च कृष्णम् उपलभ्य चिरादभीष्टम्। यत् प्रेक्षणे दृक्षु पक्ष्मकृतं सपन्ति, दृग्भिर्हृदिकृतम् अलं परिरभ्य सर्वास्, तद्भावमापुरपि नित्ययुजं दुरापम्। श्री सुख उवाच, गोप्याश्च कृष्णम् उपलभ्य चिरादभीष्टम्। यत् प्रेक्षणे दृक्षिषु पक्ष्म कृतं शपन्ति, दृग्भिर्हृदिकृतम् अलं परिरभ्य सार्वास्, तद्भावमापुरपि नित्ययुजं दुरापम्। श्री सुख उवाच, गोप्यश्च कृष्णम् उपलभ्य चिरादभीष्टम्। यत् प्रेक्षणे दृशिषु पक्ष्मकृतं शपन्ति, दृग्भिर्हृदिकृतम् अलं परिरभ्य सर्वास्, तद्भावमापुरपि नित्ययुजां दुरापम्। श्री सुख उवाच, गोप्याश्च कृष्णम् उपलभ्य चिरादभीष्टम्। यत्प्रेक्षणे दृशिषु पक्ष्म कृतं शपन्ति, दिग्भिर्हृदिकृतम् अलं परिरभ्य सर्वास्, तद्भावमापुरपि नित्ययुजं दुरापम्। गोप्याश्च कृष्णम् उपलभ्य चिरादभीष्टम्। यत्प्रेक्षणे दृशिषु पक्ष्म कृतं शपन्ति, दृग्भिर्हृदिकृतम् अलं परिरभ्य सर्वास्, तद्भावमापुरपि नित्ययुजं दुरापम्। माताजी प्लीज। श्री सुख उवाच, गोप्याश्च कृष्णम् उपलभ्य चिरादभीष्टम्। यत्प्रेक्षणे दृशिषु पक्ष्म कृतं शपन्ति, दृग्भिर्हृदिकृतमलं परिरभ्य सर्वास्, तद्भावमापुरपि नित्ययुजां दुरापम्। जय श्री श्री जगन्नाथ जी बलदेव जी सुभद्रा मैया की जय। श्री गिरिराज गोवर्धन जी की जय। श्री श्री राधा लंडनीश्वरा की जय। श्री श्री गौर निताय की जय। श्रील प्रभुपाद की जय। वर्ड फॉर वर्ड ट्रांसलेशन। श्री सुख उवाच। सुखदेव गोस्वामी सेड, गोप्या द यंग काउहर्ड विमेन च एंड कृष्णम कृष्णा उपलभ्य साइटिंग चिरात आफ्टर अ लॉन्ग टाइम अभिष्टम द ऑब्जेक्ट ऑफ डिजायर यत whom prekshane while seeing drishishu on their eyes pakshma of lids kritam the maker shapanti they would curse drigbihi with their eyes hirdi kritam taken into their hearts alam to their satisfaction parirabhya embracing sarva all of them tat in him bhavam ecstatic absorption apuhu attained api even though nitya constantly yujam For those who engage in yogic discipline, durapam, difficult to attain. Translation by Srila Prabhupada's disciples. Srila Prabhupada's disciples ki jai, Srila Prabhupada ki jai. Sukhdev Goswami said, while gazing at their beloved Krishna, the young gopis used to condemn the creator of their eyelids which would momentarily block their vision of him. Now seeing Krishna again after such a long separation with their eyes, they took him into their hearts and there they embraced him to their full satisfaction. In this way they became totally absorbed in ecstatic meditation on him, although those who constantly practice mystic yoga find such absorption difficult to achieve. Purport. According to Srila Vishwanath Chakravarti, just then Lord Balram saw the gopis standing a short distance away. Seeing them trembling with eagerness to meet Krishna and apparently ready to give up their lives if they could not, he tactfully decided to get up and involve himself elsewhere. Then the gopis attained the state described in the current verse. In referring to the gopis' intolerant disrespect of Lord Brahma, the creator of eyelids, Sukhdev Goswami is giving vent to his own subtle jealousy of the gopis' favored position. Srila Jiva Goswami offers an alternate understanding of the phrase Nitya Yujam, which may mean even of the Lord's principal queens who tend to be proud of their constant association with him. In Krishna, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Srila Prabhupada writes, because they had been separated from Krishna for so many years, the gopis, having come along with Nanda Maharaj and Mother Yashoda, felt intense ecstasy in seeing Krishna. No one can even imagine how anxious the gopis were to see Krishna again. As soon as Krishna became visible to them, they took him inside their hearts, through their eyes, and embraced him to their full satisfaction. Even though they were embracing Krishna only mentally, they became so ecstatic and overwhelmed with joy that for the time being, they completely forgot themselves. The ecstatic trance which they achieved simply by mentally embracing Krishna is impossible to achieve even for great yogis constantly engaged in meditation on the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Krishna could understand that the gopis were wrapped in ecstasy by embracing him in their minds, and therefore, since he is present in everyone's heart, he also reciprocated the embracing from within. Om Jnanati Mirandasya Jnananjana Shalakaya Chakshur Unmilitam Yena Tasmai Shri Guruve Namaha Shri Chaitanya Manobishtam Stapitam Yena Bhutale Swayam Rupa Kadamayam Dadati Swapanda Antikam Vancha Kalpataribhyascha Kripa Sindubhyayavacha Patitanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavebhyo Namo Namaha Jai Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Srivasadi Gaur Bhakta Vrinda Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama 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 Hare 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 Krishna. So we can see here the gopis are meeting Krishna after a long, long time. Krishna, up to around 10 or 11 years of age, he was in Vrindavan with the gopis. Then he left. He was having taken by Akrura. He went to Mathura to meet Kamsa. Akrura was taking him to meet Kamsa. There he spent up to age 28. So nearly for 17 to 18 years, Krishna spent in Mathura. And then when Kalyavan and Jarasandha attacked Mathura, then fearing for the lives of the Vrishnis, Krishna transferred them through his internal potency, Yogmaya potency, overnight to Dwarka, having built a city there overnight in Dwarka so that they could all live in comfort. So then from the age of 28 to nearly 125 years, Krishna is 125 years old when he is here coming to meet the gopis. Of course, always youthful Krishna, as sweet 16 as Krishna can be, but time wise he is that old, 125 years. So the gopis are meeting, you know, nearly after 96 years, like that. So long time. But actually that's not the time the acharyas mention that Krishna regularly went to meet them. Rupa Goswami clearly, although it is not clearly written in Srimad Bhagavatam, but Rupa Goswami cites the verse in Bhagavatam of 1.11.9 of the Bhagavatam, which says that, O lotus-eyed Lord, whenever you go away to Mathura, Vrindavan or Hastinapur to meet your friends and relatives, every moment of your absence seems like a million years. O infallible one, at that time, our eyes become useless, as if bereft of the sun. This is the prayers of the queens of Dwarka. So you can see they're saying that whenever you go away to Mathura, Vrindavan, Hastinapur, and then Krishna used to also go away to Mithila, Indraprastha, and then he came to Kurukshetra now. So regularly he was going and meeting the gopis. So that is because Krishna, he says that he comes for paritranaya sadhunam vinashaya cha duskrutam dharma samstarpanarthaya sambhavami yuge yuge, to annihilate the demons and to encourage the devotees by having exchanges and to establish religious principles. But Krishna, Shamsundar Krishna, as he comes from Golok Vrindavan, he is only concerned with loving exchanges. The others, He leaves it to his expansion to do. Like that. Because the only thing Krishna relishes is having pastimes and exchanges with all of his devotees according to their desires. Now here, especially in Vraja, all of the Vrajavasis, they have special love for Krishna. So therefore, Krishna is very much attracted to Vraja than to any other place. And especially to the gopis, and then especially to Srimati Radharani. In fact, the residents of Vrindavan, the Vrajavasis and the gopis, they are indispensable to Krishna's pastimes. Krishna comes, he likes these pastimes and his only business is exchanging. But without the gopis, the others won't get an idea. Krishna has these three potencies, Ladini, Samvit and Sandini, which he uses for all his pastimes. Ladini is of course represented by his internal potency, Srimati Radharani, who is the personification of his love. And Sandini is represented by Balram. And Balram, in that Sandini Shakti, he expands as the land, cows, his flute and his horn, various things and paraphernalia by which Krishna can enjoy his pastimes and make it relishable. And then Samvit, which is represented by knowledge or by Yogamaya. That Yogamaya potency, she along with Krishna works as the director and producer of the pastimes that Krishna, you know, enacts like that. So using these three potencies, Krishna enacts that. And the highest of these is of course Sambho, is the meeting. The meeting is very important because when they meet, then naturally there's that eagerness. Especially this verse describes that the way gopis couldn't even, they were thinking that the blinking of the eyelids was a disturbance. Now, I've never even thought that my eyelids could be a disturbance. That's because there's nothing so, what do you call it, that my eyes hankered after, that the blinking, you know, could not. So we can imagine the gopis' feelings, that they were saying that even the blinking of the eyes was too much. So meeting Krishna, you know, we can imagine the, and what do you call it, this hankering that was there in them to meet Krishna. But Rupa Goswami here, he rightly says that even more than meeting, he says the direct contact is not fully appreciated until separation has been experienced. So we can meet, especially people that we spend a lot of time with, we usually take them for granted. Therefore, we take devotees for granted sometimes. We don't realize their importance until we go to a situation where we are surrounded by non-devotees. And then suddenly it hits home, oh my God, you know, devotees are very special people like that. So, but that separation from devotees, then, you know, we realize, oh yeah, you know, I must come back to that association. So similarly, Krishna, he is also, you know, he likes meeting, but then he goes away. He goes away because he knows the perfect timing that's required to go away, to increase the love in his beloveds, those who love him, to increase their love. So therefore, we can see that Krishna arranges this sambhoga, which means meeting, and then vipralamba, which means separation. And from time to time, that separation could be that, you know, it could be time-wise, as it is called pravas vipralamba, which means Krishna goes in the morning taking his cows for grazing, and they know he'll come at the end of the day. But that short separation is also very much, you know, they go into, it's very ecstatic, not ecstatic in the sense of, it is sorrowful that they are separating. But there's an ecstasy in that sorrow, that oh my God, where will I meet? When will I meet him? Like that. But then the other one is the long distance one. where he goes to Mathura and then to Dwarka, and you know, for years he's away. And so the gopis don't know when they'll meet him, and they are calling out, you know, where are you, how can you meet? And that increases, and that separation, actually Rupa Goswami says, it leads to trauma in the gopis. The highest stage of ecstasy is the trauma of being separated from the beloved and not knowing when you'll meet him. So Krishna, he has two sorts of pastimes. He has Prakat Leela and Aprakat Leela. Prakat Leela are his manifest pastimes, which are for living entities like us. He especially brings all his pastimes actually with the gopis, are the most confidential realms which are not available to anyone. But we can see that fortunately for us, Madhavendra Puri brought that bar before which it wasn't available. And then he came, and then Ishwara Puri and Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, they distributed it freely to everyone. So it is freely available. Otherwise, these confidential pastimes were totally unknown by anyone before that, in, you know, so openly like that. But then, of course, the qualification is there to understand, which comes by the mercy of the Guru Parampara. So these pastimes, Prakat means Krishna creates, makes it available to all of us conditioned living entities, just so that we can be mesmerized by, you know, knowing about him, how wonderful he is. And Aprakat is his eternal pastimes that are going on in Golok Vrindavan, and that are going on even in Bhavma Vrindavan, Dwarka and Mathura. They are also going on there. So simultaneously, therefore, Jiva Goswami says that unless we realize the inconceivability of the inconceivable potencies of Krishna, we would never be able to understand all these pastimes, because they take place in so many realms. For example, he says that in the spiritual world, Krishna is simultaneously available in the spiritual Golok Vrindavan, Mathura and Dwarka, simultaneously having exchanges with his loving devotees. But when Krishna comes to the material realm, then for us, because we are conditioned, he also takes upon the the influence of the element of time. And so we can see that for the Prakat Leela, Krishna is either in Vrindavan, or he is in Dwarka, or he is in Mathura, for the Prakat Leela. But for the unmanifested pastimes, which are going on eternally, they are going on all the time. They are going on all the time in all places. So then it is said that, how is it that they are going on all the time, if Krishna is not available, if Krishna leaves Vrindavan? So then the acharyas explain that they say Krishna never leaves Vrindavan. But you said he leaves Vrindavan and goes to Mathura. So how is this contradiction, you know, reconciled? And then the acharyas explain that Krishna comes from Golok Vrindavan as Shyam Sundar Krishna. And he enacts all his pastimes as Shyam Sundar Krishna. And the Vrajvasis, gopis and Srimati Radharani, they are all in love with this Shyam Sundar Krishna, because that is his mood. And then when Kamsa sends Akrura to bring Krishna, then, you know, Shyam Sundar Krishna says bye to all the gopis, promising them that he'll come back. And he says bye. And then Akrura rests to take a bath at what is now known as Akrura Kund. You know, he takes. And there he sees Krishna Balram are there in the water. And then he goes to the cart and they are there. So that is the place where Shyam Sundar Krishna, realizing that now it is time to go out of Vrindavan to enact other activities, then he expands as Vasudev Krishna. And it is this Vasudev Krishna who goes to Mathura and then who goes to Dwarka and who fights with Kamsa, defeats armies in Mathura and defeats armies in Dwarka, and then comes to Kurukshetra and then he fights there, doesn't fight but takes part in a holy war because he is promised not to fight. It is mentioned even here in Kurukshetra when Krishna comes, Vasudev Krishna actually goes to the forest, and as he removes all his kingly clothes, he feels at home because he is in his constitutional realm of Shamsundar Krishna. Immediately he can feel that. So when did it start though? You know, one may question. So the acharyas say that when Vasudev, you know, when in prison he took baby Krishna and he went, so that was Vasudev Krishna which Vasudev had. So he took Krishna, crossed the Yamuna, and then he came to Nand Maharaj's home, and there when he kept the baby Krishna there, there were two babies. One was a girl, Yashoda Mata had delivered a girl, and a boy, Shamsundar Krishna. And Vasudev Krishna merged into Shamsundar Krishna so that they can relish. And it is not that just Krishna does it, but his devotees also do it. The acharyas give an example that when Parikshit Goswami asks Sukhdev Goswami, Parikshit Maharaj asks Sukhdev Goswami, he says, how is it that, you know, this Nand and Yashoda, what did they perform? What pious deeds did they perform to get Krishna as their son, you know, and play with him for 11 years? How could they became so fortunate? So then Sukhdev Goswami explains that the acharyas translate that they say that in the spiritual realm, you know, they are in the Vaikuntha planets, Golok Vrindavan, they are Mother Yashoda and Nand Maharaj. In the Vaikuntha planets, they are Sutapa and Prishnigarbha. And in the heavenly planets, they are these, one of the eight Vasus is called Drona, and his wife was Dara. So they were in the heavenly planets. And they didn't have any children. So they thought, we want to have the Lord as our child. What should we do? So they took advice and they performed austerities for thousands of years. After which Brahmaji, to please Brahmaji. So Brahmaji gave them the boon. He says, yes, the Lord will come as your son. So then, you know, everyone, the acharyas say that people will think, oh, then devotees, you know, they're supposed to think of a devotee in Vrindavan, you know. They might be sharing a mood, their mood, commensurate with the mood of a devotee in Vrindavan. And then they'll get that position. So it's said that they won't get that position. We will follow in their footsteps. So here Dhara and Drona, they go and merged into Yashoda and Nand Maharaj to enjoy this pastimes with Krishna. So that is how they became. Because the place of Krishna's parents and close relatives is already taken. We won't get that. But we will be able to reciprocate with Krishna in that way, in that mood, when we go back to Krishna Golok Vrindavan, like that. So got lost now. yeah, exactly. Thank you, Murli Manohar Prabhu. So when Akrura was there at the Akrura Kund, at that time, you know, Vasudev Krishna expanded, and he performed the pastimes of killing the demons, this, that, and the other. And then when now Krishna comes back to Kurukshetra, at that time Krishna is taking away, you know, all the princely, kingly clothes and all that. And he feels at home and then he merges into Shyam Sundar Krishna. And then he goes to meet Nand Maharaj, Yashoda Mai and the gopis, like that. So here it is said that the gopis can't wait. When will Krishna meet us? When will Krishna meet us? But Krishna is waiting because he has to follow the decorum. He's not elderly there. So you can see Balramji is suddenly taking that position. Oh, I'm his elder brother. The gopis are waiting. So let me, you know, make arrangements for that. But Krishna has to wait. But in the meanwhile, the gopis are saying, oh my God, you know, we can't wait because we have been waiting for this moment ever since. So at that time, Krishna, Vasudev Krishna enters Shyam Sundar Krishna and he meets them as Shyam Sundar Krishna. So, so then the question is raised that if that is there, if they are feeling so much separation, then why don't they follow Krishna everywhere? You know, why don't they go with him? Then they won't feel separation. Because the acharyas also quote that the Vrajavasis also used to visit Krishna in Dwarka sometimes, like that. And they visited him in Mathura, like that. So why don't they go? So here the acharyas quote that there is one is rasa and one is tattva. Tattva is this, you know, that samvit shakti, ladini shakti and sandini shakti, they are all used in which way? How is yoga, maya arranging? That is tattva. But this rasa principle is very important. Why they don't follow Krishna? Because the residents of Vrindavan, they are used to Shyam Sundar Krishna. They love him in that form, in that mood. And also, they love Vrindavan. Because just like Krishna is all attractive, Vrindavan is also all attractive. In fact, you know, Jiva Goswami quotes one of the gopis as saying, you know, that why should we follow him? We also find Vrindavan all attractive like that. So, they find Vrindavan all attractive because of Krishna's presence. It is not that, oh, you know, we can do with Vrindavan, you know, we don't need Krishna. She's not saying like that. She's saying that, of course, you know, but Vrindavan is also very dear to us. But without Krishna, Vrindavan will not be the same. So therefore, they like the mood because, like we say, why we say association of devotees is important. Because even if we don't feel like chanting, when we come into the association of devotees, we immediately start chanting. You know, because that mood which is there permeates the atmosphere. It suddenly inspires us or whatever, through whatever it, you know, goes in and we start doing what we should be doing. Like that. Or what we want to do but can't do for some of the mood. So the gopis also mentioned that. So they are saying that, you know, here everyone is the same. You know, Purnamasi, you know, she takes care of all the women, you know. Nand Maharaj, he takes care of all the men. And then Nand Maharaj's elder brother also does that. And then the Balram is taking care of all the, you know, boys, this, that. So everyone is looked after. They feel sheltered, protected. They know who to go for advice. They know how to do things. They know. So everything is there. And that mood is very important. Whereas when they go to, because even when, like in Dwarka, the queens know that Krishna is always absent-minded. In fact, once, you know, Krishna is in an assembly and Krishna is in a, where his queens, some of his queens are also there. And a letter comes from Lalita, written by Lalita from Vrindavan. And Krishna says to Uddhava, you read it aloud. And she's saying, you know, it's the same Vrindavan, it's the same Yamuna, same everything. But you are not there. And that makes all the difference. We are suffering, you know. And Krishna starts crying. I mean, tears come off his eyes. And he suddenly goes limp. He doesn't know what to do. And the queens can feel what he's undergoing. And they are also suffering. And they're imagining, my God, how lucky are these residents of Vrindavan. Krishna, even though he's with us, he's totally oblivious of the fact that he's surrounded by us. even though we, you know, we are like his maid servants. We are just serving him to whatever whims. But he doesn't think of us, he's thinking of them. So this mood, you know, you can see that Krishna is attracted by that mood because they are ready to do anything to please Krishna. And Krishna, because he says that I reciprocate to, you know, how the devotee acts, I reciprocate. So therefore, he is always thinking of Vrindavan. He is always thinking of the gopis. Because his heart goes out wherever there's a deep call from whichever direction and from whoever there's a deep call. So therefore, the deepest call is from the gopis who are calling him, you know, where are you, where are you? We are missing you, like that. So he's always thinking of them. And now, actually, all this is arranged by him. In fact, he used to regularly come, but in between, when the gopis, you know, when Uddhava had gone to the gopis and they found out that the gopis were actually suffering, so Krishna felt he needed to go. But as soon as the elderly heard that, they started making excuses and giving him various services in Dwarka. You know, Krishna, this is not done, that is not done, because they didn't want him to go to Vrindavan. They thought they are pure devotees. If he goes there, then he'll stay there. You know, we are not pure devotees. He will leave us. So, you know, by this. And all the ladies, his queens, they started pouting, you know, and throwing tantrums so that he had to, you know, deal with them and all that. And all the children started crying, it is mentioned. So Krishna, like a householder, you know, he was thinking, oh, how can I go, you know. My elders are saying, you haven't done this service. My wives are not in the right mood to give me permission. And my children are all crying, saying, we'll miss you. So this is not the right time to leave, so I'd stay here. So he didn't go. So Balram said, no, I'll go, because, you know, I can see that you're not going to go. So Balram goes. And then when the astrologers, they come to Ugrasen and they say, you know, what, there is a good Tithi. Tithi has come for the solar eclipse. The sun is going to be covered. And which place is going to be, you know, which place is going to be most auspicious? The Kurukshetra. It's already auspicious. But to see the solar eclipse from there is especially auspicious. And we can bathe and chant and purify ourselves and take advantage of the day. And Krishna also says, yes, yes, Kurukshetra is a good idea. Like that, because he knew Nand Maharaj, you know, the gopis and everyone. And he sends a letter to Nand Maharaj. You know, please bring all the kinsmen and everything, so that, you know, he knows that he'll meet them there. And he knows all the elderly won't mind, because they don't want Krishna to go alone. But they don't mind Krishna to go with them. So he says, this is a nice way to go. So Krishna arranges all that. So yeah, these pastimes are really beautiful and nice. Any questions, comments, realizations? Okay. Thank you very much. No, they are always there in Krishna Golok Vrindavan. They are always there. But then, you know, when to take care of the Supreme Lord, then they come as Prishni Garbha and Sutapa, you know. And then in the earthly realm, they come personally to take care. But this Dona and Dhara, who are their representations in the heavenly planets, when they wanted the Lord as the sun, they performed austerities. And they had to merge into the Yashoda Mai and Nand Maharaj to experience that bliss.
So, always they have to take a human form for Lord to be born.
Sorry?
I have Drona
and Dhara, they are demigods. They are demigods.
So, have they got to always...
This is what the Acharya says. Unless we understand the inconceivability of this is all directed by the Yogamaya potency, where everything is possible. So it is beyond the purview, the conceivability, beyond the limits of conception of a mind to conceive these. So we won't be able to understand. What the Acharya says is, in a simplistic terms, that they merged into Yashodamai and Nand Maharaj to experience that bliss. Like that.
Previous, say, Matsya, when Krishna was born as Matsya, so we did the same thing. So
Krishna was born as?
Matsya, for example.
No. That is self-manifest. Krishna doesn't have to take the help of, father and mother. He also has his, he doesn't have to be born, through a mother and father. He doesn't need that. He just has to manifest. Therefore, we have so many self-manifested deities. Krishna is self-manifested deities we have. What to speak of Krishna himself? He can manifest himself. He doesn't need a mother and father for that. Thank you very much, Srila Prabhupada ki jai, Granthraj Srimad Bhagavatam ki jai, Ananta Koti Vaishnav Vrinda. So, for the pleasure of their Lordship, Shri Shri Radha Landanishwara, Jagannath Baldev Subhadra, Shri Giri Govardhan, Shri Shri Gaur Nittai, Srila Prabhupada, and the assembled Vaishnavas and those who are listening. Yesterday, we distributed in Krishna's closet shop in Rochester, we distributed 2 small books, 7 medium books, and collected 167 Lakshmi points. And yesterday in our Transcendental Govinda's restaurant, we served 282 guests and collected a total of 1,882.59 Lakshmi points. And yesterday in our Transcendental Radha's boutique shop, we distributed 2 books and collected a total of 287 Lakshmi points. So Radharani beat Krishna yesterday. Like that. Okay, it seems there are no book distribution scores for yesterday. Okay, no book distribution scores for yesterday. And now we'll say the prayers.
Dear Shri Shri Radha Londonishwara, Jagannath Baladev and Subhadra, Shri Shri Gaur Nittai and Giri Govardhan, we offer our most respectful obeisances unto you. In a mood of deep gratitude and appreciation, we request your causeless mercy upon us. For your pleasure, if you so desire, we wish to erect a holy place of your transcendental pastimes that will attract unlimited souls to your service and fulfill the vision of your pure devotee Srila Prabhupada. For London, please enable us to cooperate together in order to satisfy you in this way. We, your surrendered servants, humbly beg. New temple for the Lordship's key. Jai. Just haven't asked for servants for I can help serving as well. And on the ladies' side, thank you. And someone to help cleaning afterwards. Thank you very much. Hare Krishna. Prashadam chain. Haribo.